What's up guys, Sal here. So Samsung saw great success with their foldable lineup, especially this year with the Z Flip and Z Fold 2, which are expected to sell in millions. And that's the reason Samsung has reportedly shifted its focus on foldable phones going forward and now considers the Galaxy Z series as their true flagship series over the S and Note series. We can gauge it from the reports that the Galaxy Z Fold 3 is expected to get the new flashy flagship features, whereas the Galaxy S21 lineup is gonna be more of an iterative upgrade. Speaking of the Z Fold 3, we have a new report straight from South Korea that Samsung is preparing to offer some big upgrades on this handset. The Z Fold 2 is already a major improvement over the Galaxy Fold, and the Z Fold 3 will keep up the tradition. First up, the Z Fold 3 will have a completely new type of S Pen support according to the latest information. A lot of you know this already, that the S Pen on the Note series doesn't require a battery for the touch input. It works through electromagnetic induction. You see, inside the Galaxy Note, there is a circuit board, a grid of coils, and a magnetic reflector. Together, these generate an electromagnetic field that emanates outward from the screen. Inside the S Pen itself is another coil that channels the power from the field to its own internal circuit board. And that's how the S Pen generates power without needing a battery. Now, magnets are bad for electromagnetic induction as they interfere with the signals. Samsung themselves say the S Pen doesn't work properly if you put a magnetic case or cover to your Galaxy Note. Which brings me to their foldables, since the Z Fold series have very strong magnets which are responsible for keeping the device closed in transit, the S Pen on the Note series will not work with the Z Fold series as of now. To counteract this, Samsung is changing the way the S Pen draws power. Instead of electromagnetic induction, they are using electrostatic induction, which does not involve any magnetic field, and hence the strong magnets on the Z series won't interfere with the S Pen. Which is smart on their part. Now, another issue with using the S Pen on the Z Fold is the display. Even though Samsung is using an ultra-thin glass on the Z Fold 2, it's still not enough to sustain pressure from the tip of the S Pen. It might puncture the display or might leave hairline dents. To counteract this, Samsung is using a thicker ultra-thin glass on the Z Fold 3. The ultra-thin glass on the Z Fold 2 is 30 micrometer thick, and Samsung is reportedly planning to double the thickness to 60 micrometer whilst also increasing the flexibility of the screen. And finally, the Z Fold 3 will be the first Samsung phone to have an under-display camera technology for that gorgeous uninterrupted display without a hole or a notch. The Galaxy S21 and possible the Note 21 will have a punch-hole camera, albeit it's a little smaller than the 2020 flagships. I hope Samsung also considers lowering the price of the Z Fold 3. At $2,000, they're never gonna make it as big as their S series or Note series phones, and since it's the third generation of the Z Fold and foldable panels are produced in millions, don't be surprised if they actually price the Z Fold 3 lower than $2,000. Of course, with that being said, let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.